free birds fly. Our love is on the wing. We had dreams and songs to sing. It's so lonely round the fields of Athenry. By a lonely harbour wall, well, she watched at last star falling. As the prison ship sailed out against the sky. There she lives and hopes and prays. Let's see you one more time, boys. Cross over the bridge.
Oh, I have fields of Bathen Rye, where once we watched the small free bird.
Hey, baby, let the free bird fly.
Our love is on our way. We had dreamed of the songs to sing. It's so lonely on the fields of Bathen Rye. It's so lonely.
After Wales win the Six Nations, it's St Patrick's Day. You can't write it, can you? All right, we're down here on Beach Road for St Patrick's Day. St Patrick's Day parade just about to start. The police and the guys are coming down behind us. So, what am I going to do for TV? I mean, you know, what can you talk about? But I thought, well, the Irish are best known for having a good crack and the pint of Guinness and so on. So I thought, let's see if we can get people to tell some jokes. And I'll get the ball rolling with this guy who lives in London. He's an Irishman. He's getting a taxi from the airport, from London to the airport. So he's in the car and he says to the taxi driver, so how much is it to the airport? And the taxi driver said, well, I'll tell you what, it's £40, but I'll tell you a riddle, and if you can guess the riddle, I'll give it to you for free. So the Irishman says, fair enough, okay, let's go ahead. So the taxi driver says, brothers and sisters have I none, but who is my father's son? And the Irishman, who isn't the sharpest tool in the box, says, no, I've no idea, sorry. And the taxi driver says, me, I'm my father's son. I've got no brothers, no sisters, I'm my father's son. And the Irishman thinks, great. Anyway, so he gets to Heathrow, gets the plane, goes across to Dublin, goes into the pub, says, pint of Guinness, please. Says to the barman, are you a betting man? And of course, the barman are very wise. He said, okay, go ahead. He said, well, how much for the pint of Guinness? He says, well, it's €3. He said, right, if you can guess the riddle, then I'll pay for the pint and give you a pint. And if not, you give it to me for free. Barman says, fair enough. So the Irishman says, "Brothers and sisters have I none, but who is my father's son?" And the barman says, "You, you're your father's son." And the Irishman says, no, it's this taxi driver back in London. Do you get it? All right. The parade are approaching, the guys in green will maybe try and get a couple of jokes in, and maybe they'll be a bit better than that. Stay tuned. Hi, what's your name, mate?
Kevin.
Where are you from?
Glasgow, Scotland.
Right. Okay, Glasgow is in Scotland, well done. And we can tell jokes about the Irish.
Irish grandparents. All my family, my name's Irish, blood's Irish.
Okay, good man. All right, so come on, give us a joke then.
Three guys walk into a bar. Scotsman, Englishman, Irishman. The barman said, "Is this a joke?"
All right, not bad. Cheers, mate.
Cheers, my guy.
Cheers. Okay, joining me now is Danny. Danny, where are you from?
My dad's from Rathmullen, Donegal.
Yeah, but you, Danny, where are you
from? I'm West Brom.
Ah, okay, all right. Okay, come on then, give us an Irish joke.
Woman goes, "I'm testing with the mum, thinks I'm pregnant."
All right.
I says, "Are you sure it's yours?"
Oh, dear. Will they get any better? Let's stay tuned. Let's see. Cheers,
hello, thank you, man.
Familiar face, it's Elfie Sykes. Hi, Elfie. How are you?
Fine, thank you.
Elfie, do you know any jokes about the Irish?
About the Irish, I thought they're all true.
They're all true? All the jokes are true?
I don't know. I'm not sure about it, but I heard it.
And who's your driver? Who's your chauffeur?
Huh?
Who is your driver?
Oh, he's Mr. Horst.
Mr. Horst.
He lands from Pattaya.
Yes, yes.
Yeah?
And this young man here?
He's from the Redemptorist Centre.
Okay. Are you having a good day? Are you having a good time, Elfie?
Oh, have a good time. Good. Absolutely.
Where's your Guinness?
Huh?
Your Guinness.
My Guinness for what?
Your Guinness. Your pint of Guinness.
Oh, I thought you meant the Guinness record. We have water.
Maybe later, right? See you. Bye-bye. Okay, Claire, I'm going to put you on the spot. I need a joke.
A joke?
You know any jokes?
No.
Come on.
I don't know one.
You don't know any jokes?
No. That's terrible.
You don't know any jokes?
I don't. Why did Nicholas... No.
No?
No, that's even worse.
You only know dirty ones. You bugger. All right, no worries. All right, joining me now is Chris. How you doing, Chris?
I'm all right.
Where are you from, mate?
I'm from Brechin in Scotland.
Okay. So again, we can have a good dig at the Irish today.
Yep.
Right? As we're all Scots. Go on, give us a joke.
Two fish in a tank. One fish says to the other end, "How the hell do you drive this thing anyway?"
Well, they kept it clean. Well done. Cheers.
All right. Thanks.
All right, joining me is a man, well, he's got a famous voice from local radio, but he's become a very important businessman in the city. It's John. How you doing, John?
I'm all right. I'm a bit warm.
You're looking a bit warm, but
I'd like to thank Steve from Murphy's Law for the smallest XXXL t-shirts in history.
XXXL, yeah. And Pattaya Trader. Now, there's a bit of a link there.
Yeah, Pattaya Trader. We're relaunching our magazine on the 4th of April.
Right.
New look, new style.
All right.
So, we sponsored it today.
All right, good man. All right, listen, so the theme of today, as well as getting blind drunk and having a bit of fun, is I want you to tell me a joke.
An Irish joke, yeah?
Well, if you can, yeah.
Okay, an Irishman owns a bar in England.
Right.
And he said, "I've had this bar for years."
Yeah.
So I said to him, "What sort of customers do you get?" He said, "I get 50% of my customers are English, 50% are Irish, and the other 20% are arseholes." Sorry, can you say that? Sorry,
well, you just did, right. Sorry. All right, cheers, John. Joe, you got a joke for me, mate? You got a joke?
Yeah, Chelsea.
Yeah. Chelsea. Joe Cox, Defence International Security Services. Good result for the rugby for England last night, Joe.
That's the joke. That's the joke of the century.
Okay, yeah, but Scotland did all right. Anyway, right,
thank
come
you.
On, you got a joke? You got a joke for us?
Yes.
Go on,
mate. Never trust somebody that looks straight in the camera
has to be an Irish
with joke, serious eyes to employ for your security.
All right. Good effort, guy. All right, it's at this point I should be checking my insurance cover. Easy now, easy now. All right, now joining me is Johnny Diamond, Clive from JD Radio. You've got to tell us, JD Music Radio. Let's get you. Try and look into the camera here for me, JD.
Hi.
All right, give us a joke, please, mate.
Okay, why did the Irishman fail his driving test?
Don't know.
Because he opened the door to let the clutch out.
Ooh. All right, on that note, one more.
What degree do you need to be an Irish brain surgeon?
No idea.
Woodwork.
Woodwork. Okay, I think we'll leave it there. Before I fall off this car, this is Paul for PMTV. Happy St. Patrick's Day, and we'll see you in the pub, no doubt. Cheers, bye-bye.